This is the first in a series of videos to teach you about SharePoint search. The goal of this series is to improve your skills with SharePoint, regardless of whether you're a site owner or you're a site administrator. In this video, we're covering architecture, and it all begins at the list and library level. So when you're setting up lists and libraries and you're adding custom metadata columns, you're going to be giving those columns names. Well, other site owners or admins are going to be doing the same on other parts of the tenant. What you'll end up with is a disparity between what you call a column, maybe it's start date, and what somebody else calls the column that they create for their list. Maybe it's event date. They're both going to represent the same piece of data, the start date of an event, but the fact that you call them two different things will mean something when it gets inside SharePoint search. Now, when the columns are read by SharePoint, that's known as crawling. So the data is crawled by SharePoint to read in the data to start storing that stuff inside the search engine. Those custom columns that were read in, those custom properties, those are known as crawled properties in the SharePoint search world, because the crawler crawls those properties. As the data is crawled, it's fed into the indexer. Now, this is an engine that processes the data and cleans it up and does something known as mapping. So it's going to map this data over to another set of fields called managed properties. The fields that were read in initially, the crawled properties, are not needed anymore, because what's going to take over now are these managed properties. And it sounds confusing, but the reason you want these managed properties is because it's going to take all of those different varied name columns that you've created, that other admins created, like start date, event start date, any other variation out there. You can take all of those and map it to one single field and managed properties. The managed properties are generally fields that you're going to create in the search schema section of SharePoint admin. That means that it doesn't matter if you're calling fields different things across your form. That's perfectly fine, because this mapping is going to connect everything into a single set of easily searchable fields. That's the point of this whole search schema. It's so users can find what they need, and administrators like you can build complex search interfaces to empower your users to find data better and faster. And if you're following along at this point, please click that thumbs up button to let me know that you're getting value out of this video. So one of the things the indexer will also do while it's moving all that data from the crawled properties into your managed properties is it's going to be populating the full text index from all the words that it comes across between your files and your list items. We'll cover the full text index when we get more into user searching, but just know that that's a separate index that's maintained aside from your regular managed properties index. Once the mapping is done, your data is now ready to be searched by users. Now, one thing to note that will change a lot of what you may be thinking about SharePoint search is that when users search SharePoint, they are not searching the lists and libraries. They are not searching your crawled properties. They are only searching your managed properties and the full text index. They're searching the processed data. They're not searching the source data. They're searching the processed indexes that are maintained. That's why searching is fast. That's why searching is powerful with the property searching you can do that we'll be showing a lot of when we get into the video that covers user searches. Now, the managed properties will also control how you search that data. We'll dive deeper into that on the next video so that you see what I'm talking about, and you may have already run across that. One other index that I wanted to make a note of is the security index, or the permissions index. As you know, the search results are always security trimmed. So if you can't see a search result, it may be because you don't have access to that item, to that file, whatever the piece of content is. You have to have access to it for search to return it. That's because while it indexes these files, it's also keeping track of the permissions on that item. So it's going to store the permissions in one index. It's going to store all the words and everything into a full text index. It's going to be mapping crawl properties over to managed properties into another index. There's a lot of indexes that are kept. These are the three that I think are most important at this point to understand. Let me know if you have any questions down in the comments section below. Subscribe to the channel to stay up to date with what's going on, and I'll see you in the next video.